Oh, man.
We have put together, I think, the most extensive and inclusive voter fraud organization in the history of American politics.
What you're about to see is very disturbing. Now, obviously, the behavior that you're seeing here fits the profile of a pedophile. Obviously, nobody out there would take liberties with other people's children like creepy Joe Biden does. And there's just tons of footage of him out there touching children inappropriately, caressing them, massaging them, basically grooming them, and making them feel basically awkward in their own skin. And this is part of the pedophile process. This is part of the virus that we're dealing with in terms of these spirit cookers. Now, check out this footage. This is the Attorney General Jeff Sessions when he was senator being sworn in by then Vice President Biden. Now, all the people are running away with their children, but Biden sees a victim. So he swoops in, he tries to touch her, and boom, bitches, boom. He's like, get out of here. Get out of here. Don't touch this kid. He knows. He knows. Jeff Sessions knows what Biden is. And the reason that he knows is because he's had many years to work with him. So obviously this man has a reputation. They know what they're dealing with as fellow senators and colleagues. But this is just some of the very strange, bizarre, and damning footage that we see out there regarding this creepy Biden. Now, look how he kind of like, you know, he's like, you know, come here, kid, come here. And he grabs her, yanks her, you know, and then he starts touching her. I mean, this is very inappropriate and disturbing behavior, but it's very classic. It's what it's expected when it comes to these kind of people. Look at him, you know, whispering sweet nothings. And this is kind of like his MO. He's basically grooming the children, trying to make them feel comfortable, you know, making them feel special, that kind of thing. I mean, this is what predators do. You know, we're seeing it again here, you know, and it's very inappropriate. He grabs him by the arm, he yanks him real close, and he's, you know, he's like, come here, kid. You know, I mean, this stuff, oh, he even tries to kiss her. This is messed up, and he's smiling. Look at this now, more petting, more caressing. Look at this, oh, he kisses her. I mean, this is disturbing. This is very disturbing, you know, and we're just kind of wondering, why isn't the FBI looking into this? Why isn't the Department of Justice looking into this? Look where he's got his hands here. He's basically feeling her up right there. How old is this kid? This is very inappropriate. Oh, here's some more grooming for you.
How old are you, honey? You're 11 years old. Talk to me before we leave, okay?
It's easier to groom a child because an adult always has a position of power over a child. I am Anthony Zankis. I am an expert in the fields of sexual violence, family violence, and trauma. It's really hard to just look at somebody and say, that person's a predator. What you have to do is look at the behaviors and listen to the things that they say.
We met before. It's great. Hard to forget those eyes. Look at those great. Eyes. Yeah. Look at them.
Can I run with Jess alone?
Very good. Very clear warning signs are adults who ignore children's boundaries when it comes to touching, kissing, holding, or tickling. They will engage in those behaviors with the child and continue them despite the fact that a child squirms away or pulls away or voices any sort of discomfort verbally or non-verbally. Most adults take those cues and realize, oh, they don't want to be hugged or tickled right now, and that's fine. Sex offenders and predators just plow right through it. Another is sexualizing a child by talking about dating or their bodies in a way that would not be appropriate for their age.
How old are you, 17?
Oh, 6.
You're turning 11. You're beautiful. Just remember, no dates to your 30. No dates to your 30 years old.
In my field, we often say that child sex predators don't just groom children, they groom families and communities. Seeing these behaviors in an adult doesn't mean that adult is a predator or would ever harm a child. But what it does do is it sets that child up to grow up in a world where they view these violations of personal space as normal, and that's unacceptable. Everyone, regardless of their gender expression or age, deserves to walk through this world with their physical boundaries intact and not living in fear that they'll be violated. Offenders have depended on not only the silence of their victims, but our silence. If we allow children the permission to say no or speak up for them when they can't, we're going to go a long way in preventing so much harm.
The new questions stem from taped remarks of Biden during an April campaign appearance in New Hampshire.
I went to law school on a full academic scholarship, the only one in my class to have a full academic scholarship. Went back to law school and, in fact, ended up in the top half of my class. I was the outstanding student in the political science department at the end of my year. I graduated with 3 degrees from undergraduate school and 165 credits, only needed 123 credits.
Biden now concedes he did not graduate in the top half of his law school class, that he does not have 3 degrees from college, and that he was not named outstanding political science student in college.
Newsweek says Biden actually went to school on a half scholarship, ended up near the bottom of his class, and won only 1 degree, not 3.
Joe Biden ranked 76th in a class of 85 at the University of Syracuse Law School. I mean, this guy comes off this whole thing as a flyweight.
Now Biden says Newsweek is right. His memory had failed him.
We gotta definitely write a song about how we do not diddle kids. Do not diddle kids, it's no good diddling kids.
There is no quicker way for people to think that you are diddling kids than by writing a song about it.
You gotta write a song that says, ooh, I wouldn't do it with anybody younger than my daughter. No, little kids gotta be big, older than my wife, younger than my daughter, something like that.
I just have one thing to say. Hang on here.
I love little girls, they make me feel so good. I love little girls, they make me feel so bad. When they're around, they make me feel like I'm the only guy.
Why did you molest all those girls on C-SPAN? At the Senate ceremonial swearings in, why did you molest those girls? It's all on YouTube. Yeah. You know you did it. Everybody's seen it.
Get out of here. Get out of here.
Chris Coons' daughter?
Get out of here.
What, do you deny it? Do you deny it? Just look it up on YouTube. Molesting children. Right on YouTube. Right on live on C-SPAN. Look it up. Look it up, Pedo Joe.
We don't want to hear from you. Loser.
You already heard from me. You're a pedophile. Enjoy the show, folks. Enjoy the show.
And by the way, you know, I got hairy legs that turn that turn blonde in the sun. And the kids used to come up and reach into the pool and rub my leg down. So it was straight, and then watch the hair come back up again. They look at it. So I learned about roaches. I learned about kids jumping on my lap. And I've loved kids jumping on my lap.
As presidential candidate Joe Biden claims to champion women's rights, disturbing footage continues to emerge, showing the candidate acting anything but presidential. Check out the following video and decide for yourself as cameras repeatedly catch Biden fondling women and children without their consent.
No man has a right to lay a hand on a woman, no matter what she's wearing, what she does, who she is, unless it's in self-defense. Never. Never, never.
By the way, I was young and I had to
Okay.
Don't tell me what
you're doing. How old are you, child? How old are you? 17? Oh, 6.
Spread your legs, you're gonna be frisked.
I like kids better than people.
Everybody knows I like kids better than people. Everybody knows I like kids better than people. I like kids better than people.
But no man, even in that circumstance, has a right to touch her. No man has a right to touch her. Period. Period. Period.
The idea that an 8-year-old child or a 10-year-old child decides, you know, I decided I want to be transgender. That's what I think I'd like to be. It may make my life a lot easier. There should be zero discrimination. And what's happening?
So you brought condoms,
What else did you bring?
Look, this is not, but that, they...
And then you sent these pictures.
I don't, anyway, I don't believe there's anybody out there believes that I have anything other than consistent interest in making sure every child has, these are all our children.
You talk about taking her out to buy sexy bras and panties and thongs.
When I ask him about his obscene screen name, he starts to laugh.
Well,
you think this is funny?
You know, I'm just not going to go there. If we keep doing that, that's, I mean.
There's something I got to tell you. I'm Chris Hansen, and I work for a show called Dateline NBC.
Oh, come on, man. But what he said, he did and does, is a textbook definition of sexual assault.
Can I go with Jess alone?
And think, no, no, think about this. But it's more than that. He said, because I'm famous.
Thank you.
Because I'm a star, I can do things other people can't. What a disgusting assertion for anyone to make.
No one we've ever seen in politics has even been halfway as creepy as Joe Biden with women and children.
Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids. Come on, man. All men and women created by the... Go, you know the thing. So there's a second thing in that black box. An unrelenting stream of immigration. Non-stop. Folks like me who were Caucasian of European descent, for the first time in 2017, will be in an absolute minority in the United States of America. Absolute minority. Fewer than 50% of the people in America, from then and on, will be white European stock. That's not a bad thing. That's a source of our strength. Were I a Jew, I would be a Zionist. And my father pointed out to me, I did not need to be a Jew to be a Zionist. For I am. Israel is essential to the security of Jews worldwide.
I mean, you know, I used to say, early on when I was a kid, I'd say, when I was a young senator, I'd say, if I were a Jew, I'd be a Zionist. I am a Zionist. You don't have to be a Jew to be a Zionist.
If you have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, then you ain't black. Come on, man.